Thank you, Erin, for being here today to do this interview with us. So we have three types of questions. The first one will be career focus, and then we will have school focus and a final conclusion. So let's start with the first question. Could you tell us a little bit about yourself? Tell us about your current position and your academic background.
Yeah, for sure. So I currently work as a manufacturing engineer for Apple on the Mac products team. So that's like desktops and portables. And so I graduated in 2018 from mechanical engineering, and I specialized in thermal fluids and did a commerce minor.
Nice. That's awesome. What would be a typical day at work for you as a manufacturing engineer?
A typical day at work kind of depends on what phase of the project we're in. So there's sort of three phases. First is the design phase. That's a lot more like individual work where I'm writing specifications and figuring out what I want the equipment to look like. And then it moves into a much more collaborative process with lots of design reviews, with the vendors, and trying to figure out like, is this equipment going to work the way we want it to? And then it transitions again to the implementation phase, where it's a lot of work on the production line with the equipment, very hands-on, getting everything to work.
That's cool. That's awesome. So you were in Mac before, and now you're working as a manufacturing engineer. What made you decide on pursuing this career? And yeah, what are some of the goals that you have?
So I love manufacturing engineering because of all the problem solving, and because every day is different. The problems that you're solving are always changing, or you're always trying to improve upon the like current processes that are working at the factory. So I think that's a really interesting way of like getting to do all sorts of different kind of engineering all the time. One other thing that I love about manufacturing is the transition from when you start the production and you're building the first prototypes, and it's really hard to build the first products. Yeah. And then within a couple weeks, the production line is running and it's making hundreds or thousands of the same unit. And it's just like really rewarding to be a part of that process.
Yeah, definitely. Like turning something small to like actually like you see people using it, that's definitely really fulfilling for sure. Yeah, so in your opinion, what are three habits or skills for highly successful engineers?
Definitely teamwork, I think, is number one. Engineering is almost always done in teams, and your ability to like get buy-in from other people to work on your ideas and how you work in a team is so important. The second thing, especially for manufacturing engineering, is adaptability. Your priorities or the projects you're working on can change in a second with a new problem that arises. So being able to shift your focus and start working on the new problem is really important. And then finally, a sense of curiosity, I think, is critical. Because when a new problem happens and you have to dive in and get curious and figure out why is this happening? Like, what is the problem? How are we going to solve this? And how are we going to solve this now? So teamwork, adaptability, and curiosity, I think, are three skills and traits that make for a really successful engineer.
Yeah, that's definitely a good point. I totally agree with you. Moving on, what has been some of the memorable or most valuable events that has happened over the course of your career?
One of my favorite things, I think, that I want to talk about is last year I launched a production line in China. So that was really exciting, getting to work internationally. And I learned how fun it is to travel for work. You get to like really connect with your colleagues on a whole different level when you're eating hot pot in Shanghai after a long day at the factory. So I was really excited about like the challenge of launching a product in a new country. And also just the overall experience of traveling for work was awesome.
That is very cool experience. Wow. Moving on, what are some of the challenges in deciding your career? And did you kind of imagine yourself doing this while you were in school?
So I definitely had trouble figuring out what my career path was going to be. I didn't know what manufacturing engineering was until I tried it. Right. My first co-op was at a mine. And then I decided that I wanted to get into hydroelectricity or renewable energy. And so I took a co-op job with Tesla, which introduced me to manufacturing engineering. And I decided, oh, this is pretty great. I'm going to keep doing this. So definitely wasn't something that I planned out. And I really had no idea what I wanted to do when I started engineering. I just knew that I liked math and physics and was really open to trying new things and ended up somewhere that I like.
That is great. That's really good to hear. What are some of the most memorable university experience you had?
One of my favorite like memories from being at school was, I think, during our capstone project, we basically built like a giant fish tank to test different ways of stopping vortexes from forming as you pump water out of a tank. And so to connect our pump to our tank, we had to get a whole bunch of weird PVC pipe fittings. Cool. So we spent hours at Home Depot and eventually like resigned ourselves to the fact that, okay, we're gonna have to order these online. And of course the websites wouldn't ship to Canada. So then we took a road trip down to Washington. And when we were crossing the border on our way back to Vancouver, the border guard was kind of like, pretty confused why we had a trunk full of PVC pipe, and we were trying to explain that this was really important for our final year engineering capstone project. And I'm not really sure if he believed us, but it's definitely fun. And one of my favorite parts of like the engineering process is the like, when you get to pick the equipment and the tools and all the parts that you're gonna buy and you're picturing how it's all gonna go together. It's so much fun. So
that was fun. That definitely is. That's definitely a really fun experience that you had. If you could give a piece of advice to your younger self, what would it be?
It would definitely be like, don't have too narrow a focus, like keep an open mind, and then try every experience that you can. Like if you have a career plan that you're really sure is gonna be what you wanna do, try it as soon as possible, and you'll learn mm-hmm. things that you love and learn things that you don't like, and then you can put those like likes and dislikes together into a career path that you love.
What is your favorite part of being an engineer?
My favorite part of being an engineer, I think, is like the universality of like, you know, all countries have engineers, and it gives mm-hmm. you so much opportunity to travel and work in different countries and work with all sorts of different people, because there's like an understanding that as engineers, like, you know what the other person knows as well, and you can work together. So there's this sort of like inherent like respect or understanding that I think is something that's really special about being an engineer.
Wow, that's a very unique answer. Well, that's all we have. Thank you so much for doing this interview with me.